All right. So getting down to business, what are we talking about this morning? A people's journey, a nation's story. We as a people have a serious problem, and my fear is that we don't even see the urgency in this matter. I think we've gotten too comfortable in this illusion of inclusion. When we talk about a people's journey, we're talking about our journey. So I think back to the history of black people in America. And I don't even have to go deep into all the specifics surrounding that history, because I'm quite sure we're all aware of our people's history as it relates to this country. But when we talk about a nation's story, all right, we need to ask ourselves a few questions, I believe. What's the narrative relative to black people? What's being said? Is our true journey even mentioned in that story? Lastly, I think we need to ask ourselves, who's telling our story? Right? And that goes for the school, the church, the world around us, but it all begins, in my opinion, at home. Okay, so instead of cataloging a long list of achievements that our predecessors have made thus far, I want to take this time to look a little deeper into our journey and try to identify some hard truths. So the scripture I was given to reference for the theme of this program is Isaiah 49, verses 10 and 11, which reads, "They will neither hunger nor thirst, nor will the desert heat or the sun beat down on them. He who has compassion," that's a key word, compassion, "he who has compassion on them will guide them and lead them." How many leaders in here today? Hands should have went up. That's the problem. We need more leaders. "So shall lead them beside springs of water. I will turn all mountains." How many of y'all got mountains in y'all life? Alright? See, we got more hands now. Alright? "So I will turn all my mountains into roads, and my highways will be raised." It's gonna come together, watch it. God is so good, y'all. Because little did I know, I was being prepared for Miss Natalie's call, and this very day, weeks before it even happened. And I try to tie it all together by referencing my most recent trip to Canada, my journey to Canada. The crazy thing about this today and this particular trip is in all my travels from here to there and everywhere I've been, I can honestly say with this trip, things became more clear to me. And I tie it together and show you what I mean. So first, before I go into my story, I think it's important to establish the context. Before we even decide to go on a journey, we need to understand where we're going, right?
Right.
And I think that's also a large part of the problem that we have. A lot of us don't even know where we're going.
Right.
Some of us don't even know that there's a destination beyond what we see, what we see every day. And then there's those of us that start out with a destination in mind, but get lost along the way.
Yeah.
So let's look at my journey back home from Canada. As I stated before, it all begins at home. And home in this case, coming back, is my hotel room. This is where the most critical decisions are made that determine whether our journey is going to be one that we're proud of and that we enjoy, or is a complete disaster. Home can be where you live, it can be your church home, it can be the school house, but in this case, I'm gonna use my hotel room. All right, so starting in my hotel room, the first thing I reflect on is probably the most important component in my trip going back home, my journey back home, the wake-up call.
Right? Yeah.
See, the wake-up call is what awakened me and got me started on my journey. And let me put a pin right there. So some of y'all know, the younger ones know I'm from the hip-hop era, so I used to perform and all that. And what we used to do is a call and response, so I want to make sure y'all with me right now.
Right.
So I'm going to say wake, and I want you to say up. Right. Y'all ready? Y'all can handle that? Wake.
Up.
Wake.
Up.
Yes. Because sometimes we need that wake-up call.
Yeah.
But in order for that wake-up call to be effective, what we got to do? We got to answer it. We gotta acknowledge it, and we gotta take immediate action. Sometimes we get the wake-up call, we answer and acknowledge it, and then we lay right back down.
Right.
So what happens then? We put ourselves at risk to miss our flight, to miss out on the opportunity, and ultimately delay or even cancel our journey.
Right.
So I gathered all my things and double checking to make sure that I didn't leave anything important, and I had everything that I needed, because I knew when I went down to the hotel lobby and headed to the shuttle, time was critical.
Right.
And I might not be able to turn around and go back for something that I left or I should have got before. This is the same concept I believe we should use in raising our children.
Right.
Make sure we give them everything they need.
Right.
So that when they begin their journey, when they get to the shuttle, they're less likely to have left something behind.
Right.
Because they might just not have an opportunity to turn around and go get it. So then I made my way down to the shuttle. The shuttle is the vehicle that will carry me to the airport, right?
Right.
Well, in life, I see the shuttle as the process. The process we have to go to get to our destination.
Right.
And depending on how far we are from that opportunity or that destination, the ride or the process may take longer, so preparation is definitely vital.
Right.
Now fast forward, I arrived at the airport. Now, if you've ever been to an airport such as Atlanta or Toronto or any big city airport, they can be a bit intimidating.
Right.
And difficult to navigate.
Right.
But there are signs. Right. There are signs all over to help guide you to where you need to be.
Right.
And worst case scenario, you just ask somebody.
Right.
Ask somebody to help you get where you're trying to go.
Right.
Just like the airport, the world is a huge place.
Right.
And sometimes we can get intimidated by things that's thrown our way or lose our way.
Right.
But God puts signs all around us to help us navigate or find our way.
Right.
But it's up to us.
Right.
It's up to us to look for those signs
and
be able to read them.
Right.
Also, as prideful as we are as people,
sometimes
we just need to ask somebody.
Right.
Ask somebody for help.
Right.
Because my mom and my grandmother used to always say, son, close mouths.
Don't
right. So that's what I did.
Right.
I told the staff where I was trying to go,
and
they directed me to where I needed to be.
Right.
Now here comes the hook. It's always something. When I finally got to where I needed to be, the line was so long that I almost wanted to go back to my room and go to sleep.
Right.
There was too many people ahead of me.
Right.
I followed too many people ahead of me.
Right.
So, but I knew that if I turned around at that point, you know, I had to be patient because if I turned around at that point, I'm definitely not gonna get to my destination.
Right.
All right. So I remained patient and I stayed alive and I waited my turn.
Right.
I waited for my season, right?
Right.
Okay? So sure enough, eventually I made it to my seat on the plane. Alright? So now I'm on the plane and I'm ready to move and I'm ready to go home, right? I'm ready to make it to my destination for this journey.
Right.
So while on the plane, the first thing I took notice of, and I've flown all the time, but this time it was just something that's wrong.
Right.
I noticed when the flight attendants, for those of y'all that flown, give you the briefing and the security and all where the exit was and all that.
Right.
The briefing. She talked about in the event that we experience a deep compression, how the oxygen mask would fall down, right?
Right.
Right. But one thing, the biggest thing I took note on is she said, if you are with a child, a child is helpless, right?
Right?
Or someone who needs assistance,
right?
Make sure you secure your mask before you help somebody else.
Right?
Aha! Get it? So, see, sometimes we get to the point where on our journey, we try to save the world.
Right.
And some of us got the audacity to point out how much danger somebody else is in.
Right.
And we haven't even secured our own mask.
Right.
Be careful. Be careful.
Right.
Be careful. So, moving forward, Isaiah 49:11 says, I will turn all mountains into roads, and my highways will be raised up.
Right.
Right? Am I right about it?
Right.
All right, so the plane takes off.
Uh-huh.
Let's go. Let's keep moving.
Right.
So the plane takes off, and we're about an hour into the flight.
Right.
When the pilot makes an announcement.
Right.
And I don't know about y'all, but the pilot in my life is God.
All right.
So the pilot said that there was some bad weather ahead.
All right.
He said that traveling through the storm
right.
would be too risky.
Right.
So we had to go above it.
Right.
We had to go above the storm.
Right.
Somebody gonna get it.
All right.
He said while we're approaching the storm,
right.
and even as we were ascending, we may experience higher than normal turbulence.
Right.
And for those of y'all who don't know what turbulence is, when you fly in, you get the turbulence stuff in the sky, right? You know, so, sure enough, as we got closer to the storm system, the pilot was right. The ride got really, really scary.
Right.
Yeah, the ride got rough. The turbulence was so bad, y'all, like, I promise you, I was scared. Like, this is the first time I experienced it. So, but I trusted the pilot,
right?
I trusted the pilot, so I just held on.
Right.
I held on. Now, I had a window seat,
right.
so I like to get the window seat because I like to see everything that's going on, you know?
Right.
The beauty of the journey, right. I like to see. So, as we begin to enter the storm clouds, it wasn't as clear as before, you know? It got cloudy, I couldn't see as far ahead, you know, so, what happened was, I just had to hold on. That's the best way I can say it. You know, because sometimes when we're going through the storm, everything will get cloudy. We won't understand our next move. We won't understand if we're going up, down, side to side. We don't know where we're at. But you just gotta keep the course. You gotta keep rising. Trying to get above that storm. So sure as I'm standing and breathing here today, y'all, we finally got above the storm. And everything came to me at that point. And it's the same thing with life. When we go through that storm, some of us just stay there. We get too scared to keep moving. You know what I mean? And we get further away from our ultimate goal out here to complete our journey. And I tell y'all what, when we got above the clouds, we got above that storm cloud, I looked out that window and it was so beautiful. I looked up, I could see it again. Y'all feel me? It was so beautiful. I started to forget that we had storm clouds beneath us. That didn't even matter no more. The storm beneath us didn't even matter no more. I was looking ahead on this journey. You know? So, what I was telling y'all, and today, when we talk about that journey, I made it home safely, thank God. But I'm here to tell my story of my journey to y'all. So, I say to y'all, my people, stop falling for the okie doke. Stop allowing a people who don't have a clue about your journey dictate your story. Stop telling the people, stop letting the people who never been where you've been, never went through the trials and tribulations that you've been through, they probably never will, and probably don't care to understand. Let them tell our kids who they can be. Stop letting them tell us our limitations. I'm telling you, there is no limit. All you gotta do is rise above the storm cloud. And you gotta trust the pilot. I'm telling y'all now, like this is so critical. And all it takes is holding on in the faith of a mustard seed. The scripture reads, they will neither hunger nor thirst. Nor will the desert heat. It's hot. It gets hot sometimes. Nor will the desert heat when the sun beat down on us. So y'all gotta be prepared. On my flight, on my journey, the pilot instructed the attendants to give me a beverage of my choice. I had a choice. I had a choice. And to quench my thirst. The pilot did that. The pilot also instructed the attendants to give me a snack to make sure I go home. So and I had those of y'all that been on the plane, brother, got a little plane where you can make the wind blow on you if you get too hot. So I'm on this plane, I'm going. It got too hot, I just turn it off. Just let the air blow on. So, and if it got too cold, I was equipped with enough clothes to cover myself. I was equipped with, my mama taught me how to do that. My grandmother taught me how to do that. The neighborhood taught me how to equip myself when I'm on my journey. Because if it gets too cold, you're gonna need something to fall back on. And sometimes it does get too cold. All right, so The last part of that verse is, he who has compassion on them will guide them and lead them beside springs of water.
Yes.
And I want to say today that our children need us.
Right.
We need each other.
Right.
But it's the hard question. Do we care enough? Like, let's be real with each other. Do we care enough? Do we understand how important that is?
Right.
Do we have the compassion?
Right.
Do we have the compassion?
Okay.
And we have to make sure that our people's journey continues.
Right.
But I believe we have the power to make sure that that journey is more pleasant now than it was in the past. And we're supposed to. We're supposed to get better as we go.
Right.
And more importantly, we have to make sure that we write or rewrite, if necessary, our story, our own story.
Right.
So that even if a nation's story does not include our story, we'll still be okay.
Right
or wrong.
Right.
All right? So I want to share with y'all an acronym that I came up with, and it governs my life. And the acronym is LIVE.
Right.
And what LIVE is, L is learn.
Right.
Learn as much as you can.
Right.
Especially the kids. Education is so important.
Yes. Yes.
And even the older adults in here.
Right.
Y'all, it's never too late to learn.
That's right.
So learn where we are now.
Right.
Identify. Don't be afraid of it.
Right.
Be real and learn where we are right now and learn where we need to go.
Right.
The second part of that is I inspire.
Right.
What we need to start doing is inspiring our kids.
Right.
And also, we need to inspire ourselves to be in a higher place in our lives. So now we go to the V, which I think is probably the most important part, the vision.
Right.
Our vision must be bigger. It must be greater. You talking to a man, and I got some people in here that can attest to this. You talking to a man that 15, 20 years ago, this wasn't me. Like, I promise you. But thank God for change.
Yeah.
Thank God for change.
Yeah.
My vision grew.
Right.
So I'm probably asking for some of y'all that don't believe that it's important to have a huge vision.
Yeah.
I was told that if you shoot for the moon, even if you miss, you land amongst the stars.
Right.
So the stars are still where I want to be.
Right.
You know, so we gotta have that vision. And then lastly, what we need to do as a people is evolve.
Yeah.
Evolve.
Right.
So what I want y'all to do for me is everybody stand. Everybody stand. And some of y'all that have been to hood stop probably know what I'm about to do.
Yeah.
I'll give you back. Everybody stand. And what I need y'all to do, because we're gonna live, y'all. What I need y'all to do is grab the person's hand next to you. And even in the middle, there you go. Even in the middle, Reg, even in the middle, there we go. Make sure we all connected as possible.
Right.
Now look at the unity. I want you to look around. I don't care if you're holding the hand of a person that you couldn't stand yesterday. It's gonna be all right today. I promise you. So, right now, just look around. Look at the unity. Imagine in life that we were disconnected. The young, the old, the young. I mean, the males, the females, so much here right now. So what I want y'all to do for me, if you really want to live, if you want to learn, if you want to inspire, if you want a vision, if y'all want to evolve with each other, lift those hands up. Lift those hands up. Let me hear you. Say, I will live. I want this church to rock when we say that, because we're going to live. I will live. That's what I need y'all to do. Live. Live so our journey doesn't die.